الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. وأعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فاتقوا الله عباد الله، واتقوا يوماً ترجعون فيه إلى الله، ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت، والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, it is important for us every Friday to share a beautiful message so that we can apply it in our lives and we can take it home, ponder over it, not just for one week, but in order for us to change our lives. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed being sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has not forgotten to remind us about even a fraction that is in existence. Because he was appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a Nabi, as a Prophet, and it was his duty to convey the message, and he has done so. So if we take a careful look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's message, one of the messages which he delivered was that we should be reminding one another wherever we falter as believers, that you have faltered here and this is the correction of it. And it is the duty of a believer not to feel bad when he or she is corrected. That is what we will be speaking about today by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are human beings. We make mistakes. We say things, we do things. Sometimes that we are not too proud of, or sometimes that we're in plain error. And sometimes we don't really pick up that we've made a mistake. And therefore, by the gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has kept us as a family. The believers are all one family, brothers and sisters of one another. In the Quran, in Surah Al-Hujurat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly says, إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون. Indeed, the believers are brothers, or we would say brothers and sisters. And therefore, it is your duty, the Quran says, to resolve a dispute between those two from amongst you who are in dispute. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us to resolve matters and not to create further issues. So this verse would definitely bring to our attention the fact that you are my brother, you are my sister, and at the same time I need to have such a genuine feeling for you that when you are going wrong, I should remind you in a beautiful way that you are going wrong. And at the same time, if I'm going wrong, I would expect the same. And there is no need to feel bad when we are corrected, because he who feels bad when he is corrected or she is corrected would never be able to improve. Imagine a person who tells you 1 + 1 = 3, and you were to tell them, no, it is 2. They feel so bad, they stop talking to you. Would they ever correct themselves? They would not. So sometimes in life we are doing something wrong. We are making a big mistake. We are, for example, distancing ourselves from Allah, forgetting about the fact that we are going to return to Him, and we owe Him our entire existence because He made us. So He tells you, you can enjoy the dunya, but not at the expense of the akhirah. That's all. You can go and live it up. You can have the best of everything in the dunya, but not at the expense of the akhirah. That's what He is saying. So sometimes when we are reminded, we feel bad. We feel like we don't want to talk to this brother or sister again because they've told me something that hurt me. But the truth is, sometimes hurtful. Allahu Akbar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us strong. So if you take a look at the narration of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu that appears in, or it is narrated by Abu Dawood, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a lesson from it, where he says, a believer is a brother for another believer. Or the beginning of the hadith, a believer is a mirror unto his brother. If we just take a look at that, it is so beautifully worded, so perfectly worded, that we have so many lessons to learn from it. If I were to take a mirror, why do I stand in front of a mirror? I'm sure we would all stand in front of a mirror for the same reasons. To look at myself and to see that there is nothing wrong. That's all. No one would just stand in front of a mirror purposeless. So I'm standing in front of the mirror and I make sure I get in front of it. If I don't have one, I will purchase one. And the sisters, mashallah, they carry a little mirror in their handbags. Every little while they look at it. They look at it, subhanAllah, to make sure that this is right and that is right and my nose is okay and my ears are okay and my scarf is okay and so on. The brothers, subhanAllah, I don't think they would carry little mirrors in their pockets, but anytime they get a chance, they look at it and they would, you know, fix up whatever they look like in order to appear good. That's a powerful example. Would you ever look at the mirror and it's showing you a big black spot, for example, on your face and you say, you're lying? Would we ever do that? Never. You look into the mirror, when the mirror shows you the black spot, for example, you never say you're lying. You wipe it without even thinking. And you don't feel bad. You can't say, I'm never going to come in front of this mirror again. No, because it's a mirror. It quietly corrects you in the most beautiful way, telling you, listen, this is what is needed. So we need to reflect our lives and we need to see using one another, you know, someone who is higher than us, for example, in spirituality, we can look at their spirituality and learn a quiet lesson to say, mashallah, look, these people are reading 5 salah a day. Do you know, if you come here to this masjid for Salatul Fajr, you will find people here. You will find people here, even if it's a few. But what should happen to me if I were a person who was lazy, for example, and I came for Salatul Fajr, I should look at those who are here and tell myself, come on, I'm sure I can do better. So it's a mirror, for example. I can do better. They are all, you know, sometimes the people you least expect to be up for Salatul Fajr are actually there, and they're there every day. Can't I do that? I've got my Jaguar, I've got my beautiful, you know, detached home in one countryside, everything is so, mashallah. I've got a little helicopter that I'm about to buy and so on, you might think. But at the same time, what about my Salah? I've just learned a lesson to say, there is someone who has more than me in every way. He's more highly educated, he has more wealth, he has everything top notch. But he is close to Allah, closer than I am. So I've got a lesson, I cannot feel bad. I look and I say, subhanAllah, this man's got everything in the world, but why is he crying in sujood? What about me? I don't even make the sujood, forget about crying in it. So this is something we can learn, we should not feel bad. So bring yourself in front of the mirror, as you would bring yourself in front of a normal mirror. Because every day we would look into the mirror. You know, people want to shave and they want to, for example, maybe cut their hair and whatever else it is. We bring ourselves in front of the mirror, we look at it and we are so excited about it. So this is a very powerful point. Don't feel bad. Take the correction. But it also teaches us that when we correct others, we should use a beautiful method. May Allah grant us the wisdom. Because sometimes the way we correct people, you know, it's like you go in front of the mirror and the mirror says, you're ugly. Allahu Akbar, may Allah protect us. No mirror would say that. Mirrors do not talk. They do not embarrass you. They do not make you feel bad. So we should go out of our way not to make those whom we are correcting feel bad. Choose a method. Choose a beautiful way of correcting them so that they can realize and understand and they can correct. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. Another difficulty, and we learn it from the same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam obviously was the best of examples. He never exposed the faults of one to another. And he taught us that that is haram. Imagine if you stood in front of the mirror and you looked at yourself, and when the next person came in, they saw the previous person in the same mirror. How would that be? We would never ever want that type of a mirror. I hope they don't exist these days. SubhanAllah. But imagine I went in front of a mirror and I stood there and I'm fixing myself and so on. I could have been in the bathroom. And the next person who comes in, and they're not seeing themselves, they're seeing a previous person. That would be absurd. So we do that sometimes to people where we've corrected a brother or a sister, then we go through the whole village telling everyone that brother is like this, that brother is like that. Is that a mirror? Is that going to be a genuine correction of someone? No. We are going to embarrass people, we are going to cause hatred, we are going to cause enmity because we did not know how to do it. So it is something we need to think about. When the word mirror is used, it is not only to teach a lesson to those standing in front of the mirror, but it is a lesson for those acting as the mirror itself. Another very important point that we have, and let me just dwell on this point I've been making, to say it is wrong for us to go around talking about the faults of others if we would like to
correct one another. If you talk about the faults of others, you will never be able to enhance as an ummah. You will never be able to feel brotherhood. We are brothers and sisters. I am your brother. No matter who you are, I am your brother. You are my sister, for example, in the case of the sisters. I should have a genuine feeling. How can that brotherhood be felt when I talk bad about you wherever I go and I make mention of only your weaknesses, whereas every single human being has some form of goodness in them if only we are ready to search and hunt. Even if you look at the vagabonds on the street, you will find some good qualities in them. You will find something in them. Some of them have no laziness, whereas we are lazy. So we can learn a lesson. We have something good to learn from everyone, but if we are bothered to search. And if we are people who only talk of the bad qualities of others, that will breed for them to be speaking bad about us as well. So everyone talks bad about each other. I don't want to see anyone. They don't want to see me. We're no longer a family, and so on. We don't feel the bond of brotherhood. So that is a very, very important point. Then, in order for us to be corrected in the proper sense, we need a good mirror. You cannot walk in front of a mirror that has cracks in it and expect for it to show you the correct image of yourself. If we have a mirror that is rusted inside, I'm sure you might have seen this, and you stand, it looks like there's a brown spot on your nose, but there's no spot, it's the mirror that's faulty. Allahu Akbar, look at the example. Sometimes you have a few cracks, or sometimes the mirror is a distorted mirror, you know? Distorted mirror. So you look and your face looks a bit wrong, but the problem is with the mirror. So this shows us that if we were to want to correct others, we need to be correct ourselves. The point I'm trying to make to you is that I need to have goodness in that particular point so that you can see the goodness. If I am not good on that point and I'm busy trying to correct you on the same point, for example, I need to start, as they say, charity begins at home with myself. May Allah make it easy for us. May Allah guide us. And the same applies. I might correct you with one thing, you might correct me with something else. It should not be tit for tat, which means sometimes, you know, I know it has happened to me once. I told a certain brother that, you know, there is some blanket fluff at the back here. He told me, look at yourself first. I was like, okay, you know. Meaning, blanket fluff is something I would love to be told. If I had blanket fluff, for example, somewhere right now, and a brother just did this, I would appreciate it. If I had something dangling here, for example, it was of a different color, something else, and someone got up and tried to take it off, I would really appreciate it. But it doesn't mean that I now need to pick on you because you feel that I've picked on yourself, so you picked on me. No, it's not a tit for tat. However, it's very important for us to know that even the mirrors are different types. So one is the normal mirror you have. Then I'm sure you've come across a specialized mirror that shows you magnifying. It magnifies everything, the hairs on your nose, totally magnified. So what happens? You can see zoom in, Allahu Akbar. Something zoomed completely. It's something that we should learn a lesson from. So this is a beautiful way of looking at it, that once I've corrected myself, I now need to specialize, go into knowledge, go and learn, magnify, see where you're going wrong, correct yourself. Don't feel bad if someone rectifies you, corrects you. We need to feel good. We need to thank Allah that someone has shown me something. Imagine if you're driving a vehicle and something is wrong, say for example your exhaust is hanging at the bottom and you don't even know, and someone stops you and tells you, brother, please have a look under your vehicle, something is wrong. And when you jump off and you see what's wrong and you really make a dua to say, Ya Allah, thank you for sending someone to me who has helped show me that there was something seriously wrong with my vehicle. Perhaps if I had driven a little bit further and the metal touched the tar at the bottom, it might have created a spark that might have resulted in something very bad, and here we are, I've been saved. So we thank Allah for that. The same way, when someone corrects you in life, brother, you know you need to read your salah. My brother, you need to start preparing to meet with Allah. My brother, the sins you've done, a lot and enough. May Allah protect me from sin and you as well. May Allah protect all of us. So sometimes people remind us to get to the akhirah, to be better people, to quit the sin. You know, some people plan sin. And Allah creates someone to come in front of them and say, brother, do not sin. Allahu Akbar. And when they look at you, they start thinking, amazing, how did this man know? He didn't know. It was just a piece of advice planned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I think I've covered several aspects of this beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he makes clear mention of how important it is for us to be a mirror unto one another, and how important it is for us to learn from one another without feeling bad. conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is all watchful. He is in absolute control of every aspect of existence. In His hands lies our happiness. In His hands lies our health, lies our wealth, lies our families. Everything to do with every aspect of creation. Remember, it is the Creator Himself in whose hands all this lies. So turn to Him, develop a good link with Him, develop a brilliant relation with Allah, and you will find your doors opening. You will be a happier person if your link with Allah is great. One of the best ways of developing this link after fulfilling that which is obligatory upon you is to constantly seek forgiveness from Allah for our shortcomings. We are indeed human beings. Brothers and sisters, the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that I've just mentioned a few moments ago, where the Prophet ﷺ says that a believer is a mirror unto his brother or sister. It also continues to make mention of various other qualities where we protect one another's dignity in our absence. If a person is absent, rather than talking bad about them, learn to speak good about them. In this way, we will achieve the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, if a person has lost something or dropped something, when we pick it up, it's important for us to return it. We have a genuine feeling towards them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه جواد كريم.